yesterday is done. See the pretty countryside.
Merrily we roll along, bursting with dreams.
Traveling's the fun.
Flashing by the countryside.
Everybody merrily, merrily,
catching our dreams. Rolling along, rolling along, rolling along.
Dreams don't die, so keep an eye on your dream.
And before you know where you are, there you are.
Time goes by and hopes don't dry, but you still can try for your dream.
To be here.
What was the moment?
How did you get to be here?
Pick yourself a road. Get to know the countryside. Soon enough you're merrily,
merrily practicing dreams.
Dreams that will explode. Waking up the countryside. Making you feel merrily, merrily. What can go wrong?
Rolling along.
Some roads are soft and some are bumpy. Some roads you really fly.
Some rides are rough and leave you jumpy.
Why make it tough by getting grumpy?
Plenty of roads to try.
Never look back.
Some roads you really fly.
Never look back. Never look back.
Never look back. Never look back. Never look. How did you get to be here? What was the moment? How did you get to be here?
Bending with the road, gliding through the countryside. Merrily we roll along, roll along, catching our dreams. Dreams that will explode, waking up the countryside. Everybody merrily, merrily, sing them your song.
Sure is a watershed.
I said, Frank, one day you'll run my studio.
I said, Frank, will you listen to that response?
I said, Frank really knows what the public wants.
I said, Frank, this picture is a watershed.
Know what I'm having?
What?
Not much fun.
Oh, party!
Hey, Frank!
The guy is too much.
Hey, the party's inside.
Bad Frank.
You like the picture?
You want the platinum touch.
How about more champagne?
He has taste, he has talent.
Is he the best?
Plus a fine head for business.
The man is blessed.
Bad Frank.
I wrote the screenplay for Frank's movie.
Your secret's safe with me.
Oh, Frank. Hi.
Oh, Tyler. Tyler! I want you to meet Meg, the star of my new movie. My old pal Tyler here is the guy who invented the telephone answering machine.
If people are living in fear, I'll invent something else.
Bad Frank!
So, what do?
He's full of advice.
I drink.
Bad Frank!
So, what do you really do?
I gotta see nice.
I really drink.
What a host!
And his work is great.
Has a wife who is gorgeous.
A son who's straight.
He's a type you can easily learn to hate. That Frank.
Yeah! Who says lonely at the top? I say let it never stop. It's our time coming through. All our dreams coming true. Working hard, getting rich, being happy. There's a switch.
That's smart.
But don't you miss writing music?
That was the old Frank Shepard.
This guy's the American dream.
And what a great fool.
If you had no idea what charisma meant,
and you just can't be jealous, he's such a gent. He's the kind of a man that you can't resent. That Frank.
Hi, Franklin.
Oh, Meg, I want you to meet Mary Flynn.
Congratulations on the movie. Your performance will stay with me for a long time.
Mary is my oldest, deepest, best friend in all the world. We go way back.
But seldom forward.
Actually, Franklin gave me the novel you wrote, and I read it over and over.
Didn't you get it the first time?
Hey, gang, we got dancing inside. Come on.
I said, Frank, you're coming down to Mexico.
I think Frank is moving back to Paramount.
What?
These are the movers. These are the shapers. These are the people that fill the papers.
Mexico.
These are the friends of
moving
Frank.
Back to Paramount.
Each one a perfect
when blank. When you see a movie that's successful, what can you say? Congratulations.
Thank you.
These are the movers. These are the shapers. These are the people that give you vapors.
20 years ago, who'd have guessed? Who'd have guessed we'd be standing here? God, we would have been so impressed. Now we're here with the most
Mexico
brilliant minds on the coast. And notice who is their host.
Mexico, beautiful Frank.
Acapulco, Mexico, beautiful Frank.
When you made a movie that's successful, where do you go?
Paramount.
Here's to us.
Who's like us?
Damn few.
Thanks, pal, for flying out.
Thanks, pal, for the ticket. I got a letter from Frankie.
Well, at least my son writes to you.
To thank me for coming to his graduation.
Yeah, he didn't invite me.
He didn't invite me either.
How is he anyway?
Oh, Frank, he asked the same thing about you. Why don't the two of you just get together?
Frank, I'm beginning my broadcast. Where Franklin Shepard goes, I go, because that is where the A-list goes.
Just figured out what the A stands for.
Now, I heard from a reliable source that you're selling the Malibu house.
You don't want it. It doesn't even have a pool.
No pool. And my rat's hole in New York, the John is terminally busted in the kitchen, should be condemned. But no pool. Trash it!
Let's have some coffee, Mary.
Poor Frank.
I never drink coffee.
He handled that well.
Caffeine isn't good for you.
I'm aware this was just a formula
movie.
He's loyal
as hell.
But my next picture, you wait.
I gave up waiting.
He's polite and considerate, rain or shine.
It began when I tasted communion wine.
That Frank.
Says mustn't go too far. I say, look at where we are. It's our time coming through. I say, good, me and you. I say, roll. I say, ride. I say, hey, there's food inside.
Frank's movie was fun.
Good thing he realized.
Frank knows what the public
wants. Not Frank.
And Frank made a star.
He's playing new tracks.
I love a movie movie.
If you have no idea what charisma meant, and you just can't be jealous, he's such a gent. He's the kind of a man who'd be president. Matt Frank.
Tonight, I was running across the lawn, and I saw a falling star right there in front of me.
And
I mean,
what do we
sign.
See in front of us? A rising star. Because no matter what the critics say about the picture, they're certain to love you.
They're certain to, no matter what they say about the picture.
The plot thins.
Meg, you know my wife, Gussie.
Everybody who's ever been to a Broadway show knows Gussie Carnegie.
The hem of your garment.
I say by tomorrow, all of that is going to be at your feet.
Scotty, that's the valley.
Have you been inside all this time?
It's customary when you give a party to attend it.
Did you sing?
No one asked.
Franklin.
Later.
You're ignoring me.
Yes, I am.
I have feelings.
And I have a wife.
I love you so much.
And I love you too.
Well, anyway, I'm off. Tomorrow I have to fly to New York.
Oh, and while you are there, do not miss that new Charles Kringas play. That is the only play in years that actually deserves a Pulitzer Prize. I say once in every generation there is one playwright who just captures the... Oh my God, what did I say?
Don't you know that in this joint you must never, ever mention the name Charles Kringas!
Mary, for God's sake.
See, Charlie, Frank, and I were once these devoted, inseparable friends.
Anyone care to come
up
inside?
Up until that famous television interview where Charlie... in front of the whole nation.
Mary,
Mary, I've warned you.
Hey, the house numbers are in from the East Coast.
And it went through the roof.
Well, at least we don't have to save the bottles for deposits, right?
And you, listen. The surprise of Darkness Before Dawn is Meg Kincaid, a starry-eyed find.
To Franklin Shepherd. Who I've known ever since we started out together back in a crummy little Greenwich Village saloon.
To Frank Shepherd, congratulations to the client every lawyer dreams of. 40 years old, a hit in New York, now a hit in Hollywood, married to this Broadway legend, and surrounded by the people who work for him by his money.
Oh, are we making speeches? To Franklin Shepherd, the producer, the man who has everything, and fat, drunk, and finished, I would rather be me any day.
Well, look at the time. I gotta get to bed.
He'll wait.
Get out of here, drunk.
Gussie, leave it.
Get that fat sot out of here.
Mary, may I take your glass,
no,
please?
No, big shot. You may not take my glass. Oh, no. Well, now I won't be invited back.
Okay,
look,
come
please,
on.
Don't all feel. You have to leave. Just because I'm leaving. But first, attention. I said attention. I have something I must say. Are you listening? You are all junk. And you deserve them.
Damn sad.
Isn't she somebody?
No, she's a critic.
She wrote a bestseller once.
I never would have believed it. She's finally out of Frank's life.
Yep. And the loss is unbearable. Excuse me.
Ow! Oh, what happened?
Oh, she cut her hand on a piece of glass.
It's nothing. It'll stop.
Oh, Meg cut her hand rather badly.
Honestly, it's nothing.
Somebody go get something. Rue, get some, I don't know, iodine. Whatever. Let me have a look.
See, when you're young and the star, how the slightest thing and you're everybody's focus.
Bitch.
It's stopping. I'm just gonna
let it air.
You two certainly do know how to bring down a curtain.
I've got the iodine. Where's the patient?
Down at the foot of the lawn.
Doing her fawn imitation.
Mr. Shepherd.
Frank.
Before I go, I've just gotta know. How do I get to be you?
Well, the worst vice in the world is advice. So I don't give any. Hey. Don't just write what you know. Write what you know. Now get out of here.
The worst vice is advice. Did you get that off a t-shirt, Frank?
I'm sorry, what's wrong?
You and that little punchboard are what's wrong.
Please, please do not do this. We have a party going on in there.
You may have betrayed me, but you are not going to humiliate me.
But Gussie, when are you going to let it go? I never said you were too old for the part. The studio said you were too old for the part.
To think I divorced a husband who worshipped the ground I walked on to marry, a pitiful excuse for a man like you.
You know, I've made only one mistake in my life, but I made it over and over and over. And that was saying yes when I meant no. Forgive me.
Don't you dare walk away from me, mister.
All right, you want to know if it's true? It's true, but what you would never understand is that she is sensitive. She cares. And she is the raft that keeps me from drowning.
Pathetic. You know, after all these years, finally I have to hand it to Charlie Kringus. That driven little runt was always the one smart enough to read your label.
And I envy Charles Kringus every day of my life.
Oh, hilarious. This coming from the man whose work isn't remembered by the time audiences reach the parking lot.
I swear, if I could go back to the beginning, if I could somehow be starting over with Charlie writing shows and trying to change the world, I'd give all this up like that.
You've lied to yourself for so long, you probably believe that.
Do you really not see how ashamed I am of all this? And I'm as sick of myself as you are. I'm just acting. Like it all matters. So people can't see how much I hate my life. And how much I wish the whole goddamn thing was over.
I found her running along the lawn, singing.
Here, sorry.
Thanks. Now, hold still and let me put some iodine on that hand.
My significant other and I wish to say goodnight.
Meg, my husband was just telling me that you're the starry-eyed slut that keeps him from drowning.
Gussie, stop it!
Oh, absolutely, Frank, I will stop it. But maybe she won't be so starry-eyed now. There's my toast to you! I may always get all that you deserve! Son of a bitch! Get an ambulance here fast! He was sleeping with a dog!
We need water, Mr. Shepherd! Water and cloth!
You said that we were finished, Frank. Well, now we're finished. You and her and me and every goddamn thing is finished.
How did you get to be here? What was the moment? How did you get to be here? Dreams don't die, so keep an eye on your dreams.
Well, before you know where you are going,
roads may wind and you may find what you've left behind is your dream.
Tend your dream.
How does it happen?
Dreams take time.
What's it also
time goes by.
How can you get so far off the track? Why don't you turn around and go back?
Tend your dream.
How does it happen? What is the moment?
With the road.
When did the road behind disappear? Where did you let things slip out of gear? How did you ever get to be here?
1973.
It started out like a song.
And that was Frank Sinatra singing Good Thing Going from the Broadway and film hit musical Husbands. The composers of that show, Franklin Shepherd and Charles Kringus, are here in our studio tonight, and we'll be meeting and talking with them. But first, the news. Hal?
The leading story in tonight's edition of News from New York. Today, our nation is at long last celebrating a ceasefire in Vietnam. The tragic death toll there having cost nearly 46,000 American lives. Judy.
On the local front, Mayor A. Beam.
Well, Mr. Kringas, what do you think?
I think my worst nightmare has come true. I look like Richard Nixon.
Charlie!
Really, do not speak to me. This whole goddamn thing is your fault. I don't know why, in Christ's name, earlier you talked me into this humiliation.
Here's the drink you ordered, Miss Flynn.
Oh, Mary, how thoughtful.
Oh, come on, Charlie, I need a drink.
One drink, what'll it be?
A bottle of vodka and a straw. Where's Frank?
Oh, Frank, well, he's probably off signing to score another movie or close a record deal. I can only tell you what Frank never is, and that's with me working on our show.
Well, when I called KT to set up this interview, I made it very clear that all you two guys were here to talk about was your next show and how long you've both been working on it.
Grow up, Mary. Since Frank married Gussie, the only working he knows how to do is working the room.
And just where did he learn that, Charlie? Off on that goddamn yacht is where, and who was it who sent him off on that goddamn yacht, huh?
Can I say to hell with Frank? Look, I've started a play all on my own. And if Frank isn't here, in the next 30 seconds, me, I'm walking right out that door.
Charlie, I know Frank. If you connect with him again, if you commit the guy today, publicly, then I promise you, by tomorrow, you two are gonna be back together working again. You gotta help save him, Charlie. Hey, old friend, what do you say? Old friend, make it okay. Old friend, give the old friendship a break. Why so grim? We're going on forever. You, me, him, too many lives are at stake. Friends, this long has to mean something strong. So if our old friend's wrong, shouldn't an old friend come through? It's us, old friend, what's to discuss? Old friend, here's to us, who's like us?
Damn few.
Charlie, why can't it be like it was? I liked the way that it was. Charlie, you and me, we were nicer then. We were nice. Kids and cities and trees were nice. Everything. I don't know who we are anymore, and I'm starting not to care. Look at us, Charlie. Nothing's the way that it was. I want it the way that it was. Help me stop remembering them. Don't you remember? It was good, it was really good. Help me out, Charlie. Make it like it was. Come on. It was so much better, Charlie. The three of us.
Would you come on, Mary? We're not the three of us anymore. Now we're one and one and one.
Charlie. Nothing's the way that it was. I want it the way that it was. God knows things were easier then. Trouble is, Charlie, that's what everyone does. Blames the way it is on the way it was. On the way it never, ever was.
Jesus, Mary. After all these years, you're still in love with the guy.
You gotta help save me, then, Charlie.
Charlie? Frank? Oh, we're on the commercial break, and then it's us. Follow me.
Frank isn't here.
He isn't here?
Then where the hell is Frank?
Frank is here, and Frank is sorry. Ever since I married Gussie, life's just like this series of meetings, meetings, meetings. Hey, pal.
Hey, pal. Long time no see.
Oh, I've missed you too, buddy. What, Mary? Mary? Oh, my God, you look wonderful. Have you lost a little weight?
180 pounds. He still calls, though.
Frank, Frank, in the chair. That's it. And Charlie, you come with me.
Katie. I think I saw my ex-husband hovering around outside. Could you see to it that nobody's allowed in? He's become the eternal sponge.
Got it. Right, Charlie. No, please. We gotta go. Get you settled in.
Excuse me, Mrs. Shepherd. I know this is inappropriate, but I wrote a film script, Darkness Before Dawn, that is so perfect for you.
It is inappropriate. Give it to me. I've accepted that if I don't want people handing me scripts, then I can never go out. Frank?
Yeah?
Did you tell Mary about closing the 3-picture deal?
Oh, no.
Please, please let me be the one to tell Charlie about it. I'm kind of waiting for the exact moment.
Oh, God!
I've explained to Frank, you compose a Broadway show, you're something in New York, but you produce a movie, you're something all over the world.
Frank! Oh, we're up. We gotta move.
Oh, hell!
Gussie? Hi, Gussie.
Joe.
You look great.
You caught me in the middle, Joe.
I was just hoping that maybe you could spare me a couple of hundred
Joe,
or so.
Joe, you can't keep doing this to me, Joe. Now, this is the last time.
I'm lining up the backers for my next play.
Excuse me, Joe, they're waiting for me. I'm sorry.
And now this evening's top news story. Today, the Supreme Court made its final ruling legalizing abortion. The court stated, abortion should be a decision between a woman and her physician. A long-time controversy now ended. Judy.
For those who have tuned in late, we are hearing Frank Sinatra singing the hit song by Franklin Shepherd and Charles Kringis. Our next guests, live from New York.
Oh, and Frank, I can't thank you enough for this favor.
Favor? Are you kidding? After what you did for me during my divorce? God.
That's why we're here.
Oh, how is your son?
Why, you want to see a picture?
No.
Ooh, but do that on air, and I'll coo, and I'll tear, and I'll carry on like a mad thing.
People love cheap sentiment.
Oh, I understand. Congratulations are in order.
I hear you've signed a 3-picture deal to produce movies.
Where did you hear that?
Oh, I have my spies.
Oh, don't worry. I understand I'm not supposed to bring it up on the air.
I think you weren't supposed to bring it up in front of me.
Oh? Oh.
Look, Charlie, I was waiting for the exact moment to tell you, but see, it doesn't change our plan. It's only going to be like 2 or 3 months at a time.
Frank, it's always only 2 or 3 months at a time.
But I haven't even signed the contract yet.
Do you know how long I've sat and I've waited for you to finish this project?
Guys, hold it for a second, can you? We're just about on.
Charlie, I have a son to support. I have an ex-wife draining me. Look, what if we write the show, we get it on, and they say it's no good?
Frank, I have 4 kids to support, and I don't give a rat's ass what they say. If I say it's good, if you say it's good, that's what's important. God, that's all that's important.
Okay, fellas, we're just about to start.
That isn't know if it's any good unless it makes a fucking fortune.
Hi, we're back, and welcome to today in New York Celebrity Spot. Here next to me, I have 2 brilliantly talented people. The gentleman on my right is...
Franklin Shepherd. Almost forgot.
And he is. Why should he lie? And I have no idea who I am.
This is my great friend and even greater collaborator, Charles Kringis.
They are the songwriters for Musical Husbands, both the show and the movie. They also wrote Sweet Sorrow, and their newest collaboration will be called Take a Left. But more about that later.
Apparently much later.
And you recently married the star of those shows, Gussie Carnegie, did you not?
Yes, that's correct.
And I'm married to Evelyn.
Yes. Now, all of Broadway says you two are the next Rodgers and Hammerstein. Lerner and Lowe.
Irving and Berlin.
Yeah. Let's start at the beginning. You're both from Chicago. Uh-huh. You both went to the same school and the same college.
No, me, Columbia. Him, Juilliard.
Oh, so your entire life you've been very, very close friends.
Until today.
Well, like all collaborators, we've had our fights and other commitments, but the magic's only there when it's me and Charlie. Charlie and me.
Oh, I love it.
Now, how do you two work together?
May I answer that?
Please.
How do we work together? Sure, he goes, and I go, and soon we're humming along. And that's called writing a song. Then he goes, and I go, and the phone goes, bring! And he goes, mutter, 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 yes, Jerome, mutter, no, Jerome, mutter, 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 that's his lawyer, Jerome, mutter, 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 do it, Jerome, click sorry, Charlie. So I go, and he goes, and I go, and soon we're tapping away. Sorry, Charlie. It's a secretary on the intercom. Yes, Miss. It's a messenger. Thanks, Miss. Will you tell him to wait? Will you order the car? Will you call up the bank? Will you wire the coast? Will you ring? Sorry, Charlie. Mutter, 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 mutter. Sell the stocks. Mutter, buy the rights. Mutter, 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 mutter. Let me put you on hold. Yes, Miss. It's the interview. Thanks, Miss. Will you tell him to wait? Will you wire the car? Will you order the coast? Will you send up the bank? And the telephones blink, and the stock gets sold, and the rest of us, he keeps on hold, and he's into making movies, and he's now a corporation, right? So I play at home with my wife and kids, and I wait to hear the movie bids, and I've got a little sailboat, and I'm into meditation, right? He flies off to California. I discuss him with my shrink. That's the story of the way we work, me and Franklin Shepherd, Inc. You know, I am beginning to enjoy this. I promise to be honest if you promise to handle the lawsuit.
Yes. Now, when you do work together, I've always been curious. Which generally comes first, the words or the music?
Generally, the contract.
Oh? Well, that sounds like you think making money is a bad thing for an artist.
Money? Did I say money? No, I like money a lot. I mean, it's better than not. But when it's money, money, when you're into money, and you should be, Frank does the money thing very well. But you know what? There are other people that do it better. And Frank does the music thing very well. And you know what? No one does it better. Still, the telephones blink and the buzzers buzz, and I really don't know what he does, but he makes a ton of money, and a lot of it for me. Right? So I think, okay, and I start a play, and he somehow knows, because right away it's... Hey, buddy, want to write a show? Got a great idea. We'll own all the rights with a 2-week out and a turnaround on the guarantee, plus a gross percent of the billing clause. There I am in California, talking deals and turning pink. Back in business, and I mean just that. Back with Franklin Shepherd, Inc. Very sneaky how it happens. Much more sneaky than you think. Start with nothing but a song to sing. Next, you Franklin Shepherd. Oh, wait a minute. I'm getting a little too deep here.
Franklin, I'd love to ask you about your newest
Frank and I are not that kind of close anymore. Frank, not like we used to be. And friendship is like a garden. You have to water it and you have to tend it. And you have to care about it. And I miss it. And I want it back. Look, nothing permanent has happened. Just a temporary kink. Friendship's something you don't really lose. Ladies and gentlemen, don't let me lose the greatest composer any lyricist ever had. Phone him, write him, stop him on the street. You'll recognize him. He's the one going through his checkbook. And you tell that man to get back to his piano. Sneaky how it happens. Every day here on the brink. First the prizes, then the interviews. Oh my God, I think it's happened. Stop me quick before I sink. One more triumph that I can't refuse. In case you didn't notice, this is my first time on TV. And my last. No, here's the point. Whatever happens, hey, then we'll all go have a drink. 'Cause that's the guy I love, the fella who's inside. Mutter, 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 quick. Kurt Jerome get the president, there's a crazy man on my TV screen inside. Bring inside Franklin Shepherd. Just right in care of any bank, USA. Bink!
Break. Thanks, guys.
Wow. That was a real slaughter, Charlie. Congratulations.
Frank.
Oh, I think you've said enough. I mean, I know for years you've been attacking me and constantly putting me in the position of having to defend myself, but that... See, I don't understand why anyone would want to so humiliate and betray the guy who is his oldest friend in the world like that, but I do know. You're never going to have the opportunity to do it again. You're out of my goddamn life, Charlie.
I'm sorry.
You're sorry. What, after you publicly mock and ridicule and belittle me? And man, I swear I would lay down my life for you. Shut up! All these years, Charlie, I have loved you no matter what you did. But I guess because I don't live my life like you or the way you want me to, you had to shoot me down and watch me bleed. Well, I like my life. So please, you just get the hell out of it.
Guys, hey, what do you say the three of us go out for a humongous drink and talk? We need to talk,
Frank. Frank, you all right?
Frank, can we go talk?
You know, there's this tribe in Africa, where if one of its members does something cruel or evil or betrays them, they never see him again. I mean, they never see him again. They don't talk to him. They don't look at him. They don't acknowledge him in any way. For them, he is dead. Absolutely and irrevocably dead.
Can I just explain what all that came out of?
Frank!
Some roads are soft and some are bumpy. Some roads you really fly. Some rides are rough and leave you jumpy. Why make it tough by getting grumpy? Plenty of roads to try.
1972.
Try. 1970. Some roads you really fly. 1969. How does it start to go? Does it slip away slow? So you never even notice it's happening. 1968.
And when you say she's not there, well, do you know when she's expected back? Excuse me, it's open! Do you know when she's expected back? But not until after the theater? Ugh, no, no message. Oh, wait, yes, could you tell her, please, not to come to the apartment? Frankie? What? Frankie? Oh, my God, I don't believe my eyes. Oh, did your daddy miss you? And look how big you got, huh? Come on, give daddy a hug. Bigger, bigger, bigger. Come here.
Daddy, we saw you, but we didn't see you.
No.
Ta-da!
Oh, come here.
What's amazing is that we're not all still waiting at the dock to surprise your boy was off his red.
What, first class doesn't get off at the dock? No, we have this big ramp at the prow and a captain who leads you right into your limousine.
Oh, of course, silly us. Now, you should have known that, Mary.
We got Beth to send Frankie from Houston.
Daddy, I have 32 postcards all over my wall. And my favorite is the alligator and the Panama Canal.
It is?
Oh, look. He brought Frankie an alligator back. What a nice...
Yeah, thanks, Uncle Charlie. It's going to give someone here real nice dreams.
Start with the trip. Then I want a Sherpa guide to show me around this gargantuan apartment.
You know what? I owe it all to you guys for making me go. I didn't do anything that wasn't rich. Rich living, rich food, rich people.
Well, poor Evelyn, my poor wife, who never comes in from our poor house in the poor country, poor thing, is dropping off our four poor children at her poor mother's.
Got it, Charlie.
Where they're expecting Frankie, who gets to have a sleepover at Uncle Charlie's. And then Evelyn is going to meet the three of us at...
Wait, where? Where? You'll never guess where.
The Downtown Club.
Charlie.
Okay, let me think. A smoky, dingy Greenwich Village dive or the homecoming party at the Colony Club. What a choice.
Oh, sorry, Frank. You really must give me a list of what's in and what's out. You know how important all that stuff is to me.
Oh, wait, presents, presents. I forgot presents. Come and help the Addie, Frankie. Now, this is for Aunt Mary.
Oh.
And this is for Uncle Charlie. What? Oh, son, about 40 of yours are right now up in the air between Gibraltar and Texas. But trust me, they are absolutely worth the wait. Come on.
It's my book. In Spanish.
But yeah, I got it in Valparaiso, Chile. It was there in all the store windows.
Mary, tell Frank the story of how success has affected you. Okay, I'll start. Mary has joined the enemy.
Charlie.
Frankie, tell Aunt Mary how many kids in your class say, when I grow up, I want to be a drama critic.
Charlie, shut your mouth and open your presents.
I did.
What is it?
What is it?
It's an option agreement. We have been offered a small fortune to do a movie version of Musical Husbands.
Frankie, take this over to Daddy and say very clearly, there isn't enough money in the universe.
You're welcome, Charlie. No, really, I appreciate the gratitude. Thanks very much.
Daddy, there isn't enough money in the universe.
Hey, Frankie, let's go and explore this monster apartment.
I'm tired.
Well, of course you are, Tiger. It's been a long day.
You can have a lie down on your dad's bed. Come on.
Charlie, I'm 31 years old. Beth wiped me out with the divorce. I have a son to support, so forgive me, Charlie, if I happen to need money.
Just do the work and the money will come. Frank, we cannot keep making our stuff the other thing we do.
Not now.
Why do I have to be poor to write music?
Because once you're rich, you never will.
Oh, come on, Charlie. We can make a statement with this movie.
Nurse, doctor, guard, attendant, matron, anybody help.
Just trust
me,
okay?
No, Frank, you trust me.
But listen to me.
No, Frank, you listen. You listening? No. No, no, never, ever. No.
Hey. Here's to us.
Who's like us?
Damn few.
Hey, old friend, are you okay? Old friend, what do you say? Old friend, are we or are we unique? Time goes by, everything else keeps changing. You and I, we get continued next week. Most friends fade, or they don't make the grade. New ones are quickly made, and in a pinch, sure they'll do. But us, old friend, what's to discuss? Old friend, here's to us. Who's like us? Damn few.
So, old friend, fill me in slow. Old friend, start from hello. Old friend, I want the when, where, and how. Old friends do tend to become old habit. Never knew how much I missed you till now.
Most friends fade or they don't make the grade. New ones are quickly made. Some of them worth something too. But us old friends, what's to discuss? Old friends, tell you something. Good friends point out your lies, whereas old friends live and let live.
Good friends like and advise, whereas old friends love and forgive.
And old friends let you go your own way,
help you find your own way.
Let you off when you're wrong,
if you're wrong
when you're wrong.
Right along, the point is on.
shouldn't care if you're wrong.
I should, but not for too long.
What's too long?
If you're wrong.
When you're wrong.
The thing is, old friends do leave their brands on you, but old friends shouldn't compete.
Old friends don't make demands on you.
Should make demands on you.
Oh, don't make demands you can't meet.
Well, what's the point of demands you can't meet?
Well, there's a time for demands, whether you meet them or not.
If you were right, I would be the first to admit that with you there is. That's only your way of the mind.
Hey, old friends, how do we stay?
Old friends, who is to say? Old friends, how an old friendship survives. One day chums have a laugh a minute. One day comes and they're a part of your lives. New friends pour through the revolving door. Maybe there's one that's more. If you find one, that'll do. But us old friends, what's to discuss? Old friends, here's to us. Who's like us? Two old friends here won't do. Old friends gotta have two.
Stop
old
it.
Friends helping it balance along. One upbraids you for your faults and fancies.
One persuades you.
And the other one's wrong.
Most friends pay for their own.
Who's like us? Damn a few.
Great ending.
Anguish, I hate it when I've missed everything.
The wife here, she misses nothing.
I had no idea the gang would be dropping in. My understudy's been going on the last few weeks, and Joe insisted as a courtesy I must see her. But first, I insisted Joe must see Frank's new apartment. Have you ever seen that disaster he was living in?
I decorated it.
I'm calling the Surgeon General tomorrow to have him cut out my tongue.
Promises, promises.
Look, Joe, it's Charles. Now we can call the night a success.
Hi, Gussie. I didn't hear a doorbell.
I bet that's because I didn't ring one. I never do when I have keys. I'm decorating this pad. The price is right. Free. Here, I picture all the furniture in here, the hues of anemones. See, a chair, a footstool, and a sofa. Oh! I should have a brain transplant. I forgot. We got you this teeny tiny housewarming nothing. Some awesomely expensive champagne. I'll open it. Do. All right, I will.
Always good to see you, Joe. And your wife.
Joe, precious, there are glasses in the kitchen, and it's Frank's house, so he should do the honors. Mushy, mushy, darling, we have a curtain to make.
Home one day, and already she's ordering me around.
Yeah. Oh, nice to see the old gang. Can they see us?
Yes.
I didn't even unpack. I've made up my mind. I'm leaving Joe.
Gussie, he'll be destroyed.
Or I will be. I'll call you when I arrive at the theater.
I'm supposed to go out.
Please. Please, you have to wait for my call.
For God's sake, I can't just
leave. I'm desperate.
I'll wait for your call.
Consider yourself kissed.
You got this guy everything anyone could ever want in a kitchen, except glasses.
Well, they're probably still packed. Here, I'll go get them.
Oh, eek! Look at me! That means don't. I'm going to the little boy's room to repair.
It's real first-class champagne.
Oh, I don't drink.
What, never?
Well, hardly ever. I'm a very excessive personality. Too much coffee, too many cigarettes, too much food.
Too much Frank.
Is Frank the only person in the world that doesn't know you're in love with him? And how many people know about those two?
Well, there must be one or two who don't.
I decided not to know. She's now Broadway's hottest star, and the guy, he's hot too. obviously in more than one sense. I say let them get it out of their systems as long as, please God, she doesn't leave me.
I think Frank's being gone the last 8 months put an end to it.
Gussie flew over and joined the cruise, you know.
What?
We had no idea Gussie was on the cruise.
It will never cease to amaze me how everyone in this town knows everything I do. It was just for the last 2 weeks.
Okay, let's pretend these are champagne glasses.
See, here you are, Frank.
Okay, you've got yours. Charlie? Oh, just one Joe. Mary?
No, thank you.
Oh, that's right. You never do. Well, more for us. To our genius.
Thanks. It's always nice to be appreciated.
Mm. Okay, Gussie, curtain. We've got a curtain.
Oh, poo. But 1 minute late. God, every column.
So, Frank, will we see you after?
No, Frank's coming with us.
Actually, what I should do is stay here and look after Frankie.
Well, Frankie's so. Here.
Oh, you're kidding, aren't you?
Oh, Mary, now let's all let Franklin get himself settled in. Good night, Mr. All Work and No Play. And everybody's favorite, Charlie.
Don't you guys stay strangers now.
Good night.
You're really not coming?
Mary, I can't go out right now. Just accept that, will you?
Oh, please, Frank. Please. Here's to us.
Mary, for God's sake.
Okay, Charlie. Let's go have ourselves one hell of a time.
I'll be down in a minute. Get rid of Gussie, Frank.
Gussie is none of your business, Charlie.
You are. Get rid of this pathetic life.
Charlie, what? I love success, okay? I love having 2 out of 2 shows hit. I love moving up in the world. Sorry. I need some time to think.
Then begin by thinking about joining Mary and me tonight, Frank. There's something going on with Mary. She hasn't written one word since her book took off. She needs us, Frank. She needs both of us.
I made a promise I'd wait in for a phone call. I have to. I promised.
Well, then wait for the phone call. Then get out of it once and for all. Drop Frankie at ours and meet us at the downtown club.
I'll be there. Come here.
You know I love you.
I love you.
And I missed you.
I missed you too.
And I want us to get back working together.
Okay, now get out of here before the both of us start wailing. Frank's old friends always seem to come through. Frank will too. So old friends, now it's time to start growing up. Taking charge, seeing things as they are. Facing facts, not escaping them. Still with dreams, just reshaping them. Growing up. And Charlie won't budge. Charlie is a friend. Charlie is a screamer. Charlie won't bend. Charlie's in your corner. Mary is a dreamer. Mary's a friend. Mary is a nudge. Mary is a purist. Charlie's a judge. Charlie is a dropout. Everything's a cop-out. Why is it old friends don't want old friends to change? Every road has a turning. That's the way you keep learning.
so, old friends, don't you see we can have it all? Moving on, getting out of the past. Solving dreams, not just trusting them, taking dreams, readjusting them, growing up. Growing up. Trying things, being flexible, bending with the road. Adding dreams when the others don't last. Growing up, understanding that growing never ends. Like old dreams, well, some old dreams. Like old friends.
Stop.
I thought you were going to call.
I said I had a headache and had the car bring me back here.
I have plans. Gussie, I'm going to see Mary and Charlie. Look, there's something I have to say to you.
I sent the driver back to take my things to a hotel.
No, Gussie, you can't do that. We've already destroyed one marriage. I could never live with you leaving Joe for me.
I'm leaving him for me.
Why? Why suddenly? Why tonight?
I saw tonight that I could lose you.
My friends are waiting.
Your friends will be there for you tomorrow. I need you tonight. Life is knowing what you want. Darling, that's the only thing to know. As I told you moons ago, darling, nothing wrong with wanting. Nothing wrong with wanting me, darling. Also nothing wrong with not. Though it's only fair that you should be aware that I want you a lot. Growing up means admitting the things you want the most. Can't pursue every possible line. Letting go, making choices, ignoring all other voices, including you want, darling, not on what you think you should, not on what you want to want, darling, not from force of habit. Once it's clearly understood, darling, better go and grab it. Things can slip away for good, darling. What is it you really?
Pretty countryside, merrily we roll along, roll along, gathering dreams. Traveling's the fun, flashing by the countryside, everybody merrily, merrily. following dreams, rolling along.
In the case of Shepherd versus Shepherd, after serious consideration, I have made a decision to close this courtroom to both the press and the public. After a one-hour recess, we will reconvene behind closed doors with the next subpoenaed witness. This court is now adjourned.
Hey!
Oh, great, you've missed the star going in. Stay close, we'll try to grab her coming out.
I left the minute the peace march broke. What have you got?
Composer's wife who wants every last cent plus the kid.
Oh. Really?
This cat's gonna be lucky if they let him keep his clothes.
I thought you got something hot.
Look, after the judge reads the deposition of the star witness and suddenly closes the courtroom to the public, trust me, I got something hot.
It's an innocent little friendship that's been blown totally out of proportion.
You're a big star. You've got to know better, right?
Hold it, Miss Carnegie. Why were you subpoenaed?
Financial records, percentage, how's a ride?
Miss Carnegie, how are you two involved in this scandal?
Listen, we're not involved.
And it is not a scandal. We have no comment.
Can you tell us why you are subpoenaed to testify today?
My wife and me, we are Mr. Shepherd's best friends, I guess is why.
Do you not understand? We have no comment.
Come on, let's go.
And the public knows no comment means guilty as hell. Any statement for the press, counselor?
I have no statement. Stay with me.
I understand Gussie Carnegie is scheduled to testify this afternoon in a closed courtroom.
That's what we understand.
Why?
We have no idea.
Well, maybe Mr. Shepherd could explain. Isn't Mr. Shepherd coming out?
Mr. Shepherd just left by a side exit.
I know that exit!
Oh, great.
Go get him, Charlie. Frank, this has gone on long enough.
We all think you should get out of this any way you can.
Give Beth whatever she wants.
But Charlie, she wants everything.
I warned you in the beginning, Frank. Settle for whatever, but settle. A woman charging abandonment of wife and child? Come on.
Beth wants to move to Houston with my son, Jerome. I'll never allow that. Never.
You know what they're planning on doing today, Frank? With Beth sitting there, with your kid on her lap.
Stop it now. Walk away. Take a trip.
Save yourself all this pain.
But I can't just lose my family.
Frank, I've taken that yacht. You're gonna come on this cruise with me. You'll get away. You'll get some rest.
And when you get back, you can stay with me.
Go, Frank. Go. We all want you out of this. Go. Get away.
I can't live without my son. Beth!
Frank, don't make it worse.
Not gonna give up, Jerome.
Daddy, wait for me.
Oh, don't be a fool, Elizabeth.
Except wait. Mommy, we'll be right back. Okay. You go with Grandpa.
Your mother would turn in her grave.
Daddy!
Come on, darling.
I want to see you, mm-hmm. Daddy!
I want you to give up, Frank.
Never. It's not life without my son.
You're not gonna like what you hear this afternoon. I'm not out to hurt you, Frank, but I'll hurt you if I have to.
How is Frankie?
How do you think he is, Frank? You know, all I keep thinking is I could have stopped it. I was warned about Gussie. I could have stopped.
Do you still love me?
Did you sleep with her, Frank?
Do you still love me?
Not a day goes by. Not a single day, but you're somewhere a part of my life, and it looks like you'll stay as the days go by. I keep thinking, when does it end? Where's the day I'll have started forgetting? But I just go on thinking and sweating and cursing and crying and turning and reaching and waking and dying. And now, not a day goes by, not a blessed day, but you're still somehow part of my life, and you won't go away. So there's hell to pay, and until I die, I'll die day after day after day after day after day after day after day.
Gussie.
I love you, Beth.
Did you want that kind of life so much that you went with her?
But I'll always love
you. But did you?
Yes.
Frank,
Daddy!
No,
you just see me, Grandma's here. Daddy, would you take
him? He's my child, too! Get out of here!
I can't live like this.
Wait, for God's sake! Are you satisfied?
It's my job, man.
Yeah, then go find a decent one, man!
Frank! Frank, take it easy, pal! Take it easy! Cool off!
Look, I'll kill those photos, genius. But you owe me one.
Listen to Charlie and me, Frank. We want you to get away.
Just hold me, Mary. Wait, no. All I want to do is get back to work. I have to work.
No shape to write, pal. Go off with Tyler.
But I don't want to go away!
I am your agent, and I'm telling you, now is not the time to work.
I love you, Frank. And Charlie loves you. Listen to us.
Living well is the best revenge.
So you've made a mistake, so you're singing the blues, so you'll take some time, go visit some places.
You gotta be somewhere where there's nothing to remind you, right?
What you need is a break. I'll arrange a nice cruise. You relax a bit and see some new faces.
You gotta do something, but just never look behind you. Right?
Best thing that ever could have happened.
Right. So you sit in the sun, you'll come back with a tan, then we'll do that show you've always been talking.
The side is retired, so we start another inning. Right?
On a boat is such fun.
You'll come back a changed man.
I have lots of guests and no one squawking.
Feels like an ending, but it's really a beginning. Right?
Best thing that ever could have happened. All right, now you know, life is crummy, well, now you know. I mean, big surprise, people love you and tell you lies. Bricks can tumble from clear blue skies. Put your dimple down, now you know. Okay, there you go, that's the sum of it, now you know. It's called flowers wilt, it's called apples rot, it's called thieves get rich and saints get shot. It's called God don't answer prayers a lot. Okay, now you know. Okay, now you know. Now forget it, don't fall apart at the seams. It's called letting go your illusions. And don't confuse them with dreams if they're going slow. Don't regret it and don't let's go to extremes. It's called watch your choice, it's called count to ten. It's called burn your bridges, start again. You should burn them every now and then or you'll never grow. Because now you grow, that's the killer is now you grow. You're right, nothing's fair and it's all a plot. And tomorrow doesn't look too hot. Right, you better look for what you got. Over here, hello. Okay, now you know. Right?
So you find a little gal, so you write a little play. In a month or two, you're going to thank us.
You may have missed one road, but there's plenty more to follow. Right?
I'll go through the canal, up the coast to L.A. You come see that place I'm building at Trancas.
Hang around here, pal, and you're only gonna wallow. Right?
Best thing that ever could happen.
I mean, you'll come back. I mean, what's the fun?
I mean, sea and sun and comfort plus.
Happen.
I mean, after all, you still got us.
Best thing that ever could.
Let go, gotta do it from scratch. Take a long, deep breath. Go back to your source as a little vacation, which is all about forgetting, right?
Right!
Right, then we'll do a new show. No, we'll do a whole batch. Maybe one that's all about divorces. I mean a divorce court. What a fascinating setting, right?
Right!
Right.
Right.
Best thing that ever could have happened.
Yesterday is gone. See the
bright, safe,
stars.
So you sit in the sun, you come back with a tan, and a month.
It's yours.
look too hot. You better look at what you got over here. Hello.
Inside, or did you forget?
Oh, Joe, we're so sorry, but something amazing happened.
Yeah, I'll say amazing when suddenly right before the 11 o'clock number, this whole pack of you jumps right up out of your seats, turns, races straight down the center aisle like a bunch of mashuganas.
It was Evelyn, just like that. She went into labor.
And being Evelyn, she wouldn't tell us until her pains were only 5 minutes apart. We only a second ago got her into her cab.
Well, then what the hell are you doing here?
My wife would not let me into the cab.
Evelyn refused to let Charlie miss our first opening night.
Well, she even brought a tape recorder to record the applause.
From your mouth to God's ear.
Now, Charlie, the second the applause is over, I have a taxi waiting. You, me, and Beth are going to fly to that hospital in record time, I promise.
They're quiet.
Very quiet.
When an audience is quiet like that, it means they're really concentrating. Shut up, Mary.
We should go back in for the closing. I didn't mean the closing.
Here, Mama, now that cab with the meter running right there, that's for Charlie. So you and Daddy take the one right behind us.
I'll see you very soon, little bit. And I'm going to tell you every single thing that happens, okay? Because I wanted him to be here opening night.
Frank, now he's been here opening night. Mama, hurry. We both thank you very much. We both love you very much. Now hurry.
I still don't understand why in hell any human being in their right mind would ever, ever want to live in New York City.
Charlie, let's write another show.
Yay! And then another, and then another, and then another.
I'll produce it.
Wait a minute, Joe. You'll produce Take a Left.
I say first you get yourselves a couple of hits to show them you can make money. Then you can do the political flop to show them you got integrity. Me, I got such an idea for you guys. So commercial. First you'll hate it. Then you'll love it.
Frank, you know I never say anything, but I am going to say this. For me. Just do one more for Joel, then you can go do Take a Lift.
Beth, I know the kind of music I want to write. Look, I know things are hard for you right now, but I'm asking you to trust me, okay?
And I'm asking you to trust me.
Beth, look, guys, now is the time. You got to do your own stuff.
You don't have a child, Mary. And you just had yourself a bestseller, so of course it's all very easy for you to say.
Oh, Beth, believe me. Success ain't all it's cracked up to be.
Yeah, I think Charlie and I are going to handle success very well.
Yeah, I mean, look how well we've handled failure.
Listen to that. Would you listen to that? Do you know what that means? Let me tell you what that means. Wait, no, anyone who even thinks it, don't say it, you'll jinx it.
Listen to that.
Did you listen to that? Here, does that make you feel proud? Well, feel more than just proud. Okay, wait, I'll tempt fate and I'll state it out loud. That's the sound of a hit. It's a hit. Gang, I think this is it. No more writing clever little shows for those basement saloons. No more proclamations from the pros that you can't hum the tunes.
No more sneaking it at intermission to the plays you wish you could afford.
Or producers having you audition whenever they're bored.
And you say right away as you play the first chord. Boys, it's very, what is the word? Interesting. Oh. And if I even had the slightest belief that any audience would come see it, I would produce it in a second. Next! We're a hit! Standing up the whole bit!
No more coaching those sopranos with voices like bees.
No more secondhand pianos with six broken keys.
No more agents giving you opinions as they turn you over to their minions.
Just for these guarantees we should please thank the Lord. It's a hit! It's a hit!
Will my folks have a fit after all that baloney they made me go through? All that honey, not that he's a phony, but what does he do? Will their faces be stony when they see on their Sony someone handing the phony the Tony Award?
I would like to begin by thanking all the hundreds of people who have turned down every show that I have ever written so that I could win tonight for this one.
Listen to that. Will you listen to that?
Tell me, is that a noise or is that a noise? That is a noise we've been waiting the whole of our lives to hear.
Listen to that.
Listen to that.
Listen to that.
Listen to that.
I can't. Is that a noise? That is the loveliest noise heartbreaking life to hear.
Listen to that. That's a noise.
That is a noise. That is really a noise.
I can't
stand it. Would you listen to that? Would you listen to that? That's the sound of an audience losing its mind. It's the Pope on his balcony, blessing mankind.
Folks, it's Funny Girl, Fiddler, and Dolly combined.
It's a hit, it's a hit, it's a palpable hit.
Only even runs a minute. At least it's a witch. It's the theater and we're really in it, not just on the edge.
If your spirits have been needing proving, you can drop in any night for free.
But the thing that's positively moving,
you could have fooled me, is we're still old friends. Nothing can kill old friends. Where there's a will, old friends don't need success to survive. And us old friends, what's to discuss, old friends? We've got a show by a genuine, wobbling blockbuster. Lines down to Broadway before.
a sensational box office lollapalooza gargantuan. Hit! It's a 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 hit!
This is the moment everybody lives for. Now we go in and we fake being modest.
No, I'm gonna have a baby.
Oh, what coming. About the opening party?
Well, you two go to the party. Frank, I'll do one more for Joe Josephson. But just one more.
One more. And then it's our time.
One more.
Frank, I was there for Evelyn's last baby, and I want to be there for this one, too. But you go on ahead.
But absolutely not. No.
Yes. I'm so proud of you. And if I don't see you at the hospital, I'll see you at home. I love you so much. Come on.
Beth, with Gussie there, I urge you, stay with Frank.
Sometimes you have to trust, Mary.
And sometimes you don't.
I would never want a man I couldn't trust.
Hey, big man, you got a ride to this fancy schmancy party?
Oh, I can only stay 2 or 3 minutes.
Oh. Was that not why we do all this? Was that not just heaven?
Oh, wow.
Listen, I gotta go make nice with the backers, so you two take our car. I won't be able to afford this big man now. You watch.
What a blessing it's been to find another pure artist. So often I've just wanted to thank you, but Franklin Shepherd, I think there has been a conspiracy to keep you from me.
Miss Carnegie, I owe you so much.
Didn't I tell you a few years ago it was fate that brought us together? Now you, all you have done these past few months is work, work, work. Tonight, let me show you how divine it is to be number one. Everybody's waiting to meet the man of the hour.
Dreams don't die, so keep an eye on your dreams.
Cause before you know where you are, there you are.
Time goes by and dreams go dry, but you can't give up on your dreams.
Tend your dreams.
Some roads are easy.
Dreams take time.
Roads are all uphill.
Time goes
up real quick. What
a walk with a will.
Some roads you travel just for the thrill.
Bend your dreams.
Some roads are breezy.
Some roads are full of jiggles and bumps.
Can't let it get you down in the dumps.
Don't let it get you down in the dumps.
1964.
Have you seen?
How was it?
You're not serious.
Do you mean?
Does it?
You're not serious.
Have you seen?
How was it?
You're not
we
serious.
We bought the best.
Does it?
You're not serious.
Did you see?
How was it?
We saw the first. Did you ever? Frank, it's the mayor. God.
I know.
Frank, look, it's my favorite actress.
I see.
Yeah, but do you see who she's with?
No, Beth, I'm not looking for celebrities. I'm looking for Charlie.
Well, Frank, you can do both. I never saw so many famous people!
Ah! What, who, where?
What do you say?
I haven't talked to him yet, but I'm pretty sure he didn't invite us here because we'd fit in so well. I'm more sure than ever that he wants to option our show.
I'm sure too, but let's not be too sure. I just have the pastry concession. You're the one supposed to handle the business.
Well, I'm handling it, Charlie. You watch. All this work we've put into our writing, it's finally gonna pay off.
Well, I don't care what he asks, you just say yes. All I want is for us to be rich as long as we've been poor.
Shh, Beth. There's a lot of sophisticated people here.
Oh, God. If I'd known that, I would have worn earrings.
Oh, my gosh. Come on. Let's go.
What's going on?
Those people over there, they're smoking marijuana.
I smelled that before in the village.
I thought it was autumn.
Darling, we saw the new
darling.
We had the most brown, it was good, it's the biggest. But a cat, but it used to was the dumbest.
Hi, I'm Franklin Shepard. I don't know if you remember me. This is Charles Kringus, who writes my lyrics.
Remember you? You're the reason we're giving this bash, according to our accountant, anyway.
Oh, sorry, this is Beth, my wife, Beth.
Do you write songs, too?
No, right now I'm the family breadwinner.
You don't mind if I kidnap him, do you? I have invited the richest and the most influential people in this town tonight, not one of whom is as rich or as influential as you are going to be. I call them the blob. They absorb everything. Meet the blob, the bodies you read about, the ones who know everyone that everyone knows.
Hi, triple fabulous!
Meet the blob, not many and yet,
right.
You never see one.
What? No!
They come as a set.
Okay.
And we're in their debt.
But what do you think?
'Cause Honey Bunch, they write the books and put on the shows and run the saloons and design the clothes. They keep us natives on our toes.
I'll be warm.
And they read the books and go to the shows and swamp the saloons wearing all the clothes. What you might call a glut, but they're the most important people in the most important city, in the most important country, in the you know what.
Heavy Milltown Gestalt.
Beth, darling, you don't have any hooch. No, I am going to open my veins.
Oh, it's okay. It better be, since now I own it.
Joe, hurry. We have a gigantic catastrophe. Oh, this is scandalous. Joe, take this gorgeous person up to my closet, and she's going to chew some rag of mine. Move, Joe, please. I am paralyzed with shame.
Did you talk to my wife? We got something in mind. Maybe for Broadway.
Joe, if you do not hurry, I am going to throw myself down the garbage disposal. Now move.
Excuse my wife.
No, your new songs are just beautiful.
Oh, I brought over some newer ones, actually.
You're wonderful.
I just admire people like you so much. You seem to know everyone and do everything.
Yes, I do. One day I just made myself up, and now I never change.
Yeah.
I just change the people around me. Scotty? Precious, this is your new client, Franklin Shepard.
You can give me a holler tomorrow, or I'll yell on you. I'm in the book.
So am I.
See, look how much you two have in common. I just found you an agent. Joe gave me this greenhouse as a wedding present. He has a tendency to worship me.
It's great.
If you like it, you can take it home.
Yeah.
I married Joe because he liked me and I liked his life. I married the one before because, well, I believed him when he said he could write. And the first one? Well, I don't think first ones really count, do you?
Now, this greenhouse seems as out of place in New York as I do.
Only at first, darling. Now I find it the best thing about this dump. How old are you?
25. Which doesn't bother me, but then I think I'm like a quarter of a century and I panic. Well, so much I want to do and I can't get started. I can't even... What?
Here's something I do when I want to get to know somebody very well, very fast. It's a game. I tell you something honest about me and you answer me right away with something honest about you. I call it trading hostages. I'm not very happy. Go on, I'm not very happy.
I'm very happy.
I'm inches away from the top.
I'm miles away from the top. Make that hundreds of thousands of miles away.
Performing is my life.
Composing is my life.
Success isn't happening fast enough.
Success isn't happening at all.
I've been in 5 Broadway shows.
I've seen the second act of every one.
Someone's cheating. I've done 5 Broadway shows.
Me, I can't get started. I can't even
start my first love is singing.
My first love is music.
My second love is acting.
My second love is music.
I believe it's fate that brought us together. Anywho, I did all those Broadway shows, most of which didn't last as long as this conversation, and Joe has just optioned a vehicle that could change my life. And yours. We both want you and your partner to do the score. Is that disappointment I see on that sweet face?
No. It's just we were hoping he wanted to do Take a Left. You know, the show Charlie and I auditioned for him.
Oh, no, darling, not at all.
Well, it's just we've been working on it for like 3 years now.
Well, you can do this one much faster. But he wants me to make sure you understand we want it fast, loud, and funny. Yeah. I need a hit. What do you say? Life
is knowing what you want. Darling, that's the thing you have to know. You'll get everything you want. Darling, have a little patience. Climbing mountains can be slow. Darling, take it easy as you climb. I'd say you're a winner, also a beginner. One step at a time. Growing up, it's what they call growing up. It's when we're all starting out and starting to swing. Growing up, you hate the delay, but after today, you'll be on your way. So what do you say?
Okay.
Now, this show is not about subtle and it's not big on depth. It's flash, bam, curtain. It's fun. It's opulent. It's Broadway.
Okay.
What was that? A second thought?
No. It's just something I do when I want to hold on to a moment. I close my eyes very tight and I swallow. It's like I take a picture that I can treasure.
You're a treasure. Now, I want everyone who hasn't drunk, smoked, or gorged too much to hurry over here. Chop, chop.
Frank, would you look at this?
Honey, it looks beautiful. But Mary, where have you been?
I had to borrow a dress.
From the guy upstairs.
Oh, darling, that looks wonderful on you. Keep it. I'm too fat to wear it anyway.
Oh, Gussie, this is our friend, Mary Flynn. Mary's a copy editor, but real soon she's got her first book coming out.
Sorry I'm late. So glad you didn't wait.
Mary, Charlie, and Frank are these totally inseparable friends.
Oh, I'm going to have to separate for a minute. I have to go find Charlie, so...
Oh, no, I have plans for you. Mary Flynn, would you be as sweet as you look and go get Charlie? Thank you this much. I think your husband is the most talented composer I've ever heard. I hope it's all right that I'm crazy about him.
I hope it's all right, too.
Okay, quiet, everybody! Please, quiet!
Now listen, because one day you are all going to be able to say, I was there when. Oh. I have, standing next to me, the most exciting composer ever, ever, ever. And he's going to play you a song he has written. And when he has finished, you are all going to want to swallow poison because there will be nothing more to live for. So, find a place to park it, ferme all those bouches. And I am honored to now present Franklin Shepherd and Charles... some funny name... I'm so sorry. Anyway, this is a song from a little show that they want to do that we hope will be in our big show we want to do.
In a big show? Frank, what the hell is she talking about?
Later. See?
It started out like a song. We started quiet and slow, with no surprise. And then one morning I woke to realize we had a good thing going. It's not that nothing went wrong. Some angry moments, of course, but just a few. And only moments, no more, because we knew we had this good thing going. And if I wanted too much, was that such a mistake at the time? You never wanted enough. All right, tough, I don't make that a crime.
it's going along. You take for granted some love will wear away. We took for granted a lot, and still I say we could have kept on growing instead of just kept on. We had a good thing going, going, gone.
Want to hear it again?
Yeah.
Down low. Wouldn't you just love to live your entire life by that music? Down, everybody, down, down, down. They're gonna play it again. One more time.
No, Frank, say no.
Charlie's right.
I loved it.
I thought we were great.
You know what true greatness is? There's no one to get off.
Come on, I'll sing with you.
It started out like a song. Started quiet and slow with no surprise, and then one morning I woke to realize
I said, Joe, this show will be a watershed.
It's not that nothing went wrong. Some angry moments, of course, but just a few. And only moments, no more, because we do. We have this good thing to always.
We need to read and everything just for the truth. What we need to do is ever so much.
It's a show that'll matter as it does. It's a genius, it's a talent, and all the other teams. It's the greatest, it's a single, it's the only, it's a perfect, it's a one.
Such wonders it has brought, you hardly know where to begin. There's Xerox and lasers, the twist and the pill, a city in Brazil
that no one wants to fill.
Khrushchev stopped screaming, and Librium came in,
and Nixon didn't win.
Goodbye then to I Am the Brass, 2 years that were cozy but crass. It's true, Ike was icky,
but better him than Dicky.
Now meet the first family with class en masse. Oh.
There's Bobby
and Jackie
and Jack and myriads more in the back. There's Ethel and Teddy and Pat alone,
plus Eunice
and Peter
and Jean
and Joe
and what's his name?
Steven.
And hold the phone, the one in the Ami.
One in the Ami?
Captain, Major,
Sergeant.
That's it.
So many cards in the pack, you'll want to know how to keep track. Well, one is good looking and young and rich. Well, one is good looking and young and rich. The rest are good looking and young and rich. There isn't a lot that they lack.
Not Bobby and Jackie and Jack and Ethel and Ted and Eunice and Pat and Joan and Steve and Peter and Jean and Sarge. There's probably dozens of others at large. God knows. And Joe and Rose.
Oh, Bobby. 29, 32, 54. Hey.
Bobby, go long.
We're bringing back style to the White House.
I'm painting it beige for a start.
We're making it into a cultural lighthouse
for glamour
and beauty
and art.
Evenings of the Budapest playing Vivaldi and Munch doing bits of Ravel. I'll get Leontine Price to sing a medley from Meistersinger and Margot Fonteyn to dance Giselle. Won't it be perfectly swell?
We'll have Bernstein play next on the Bechstein piano.
And Auden read poems and stuff.
And Galina Wisniewski.
Gesundheit.
The Russian soprano. Just pronouncing her name is refreshing enough.
We're bringing back style to the White House. Casual culture, the rule.
Let's have Tibaldi.
She makes a guy feel good.
And Oleg Cassini. Well, I think he's real good.
And how about Heifetz?
And Callas.
And Gielgud.
And later, when everything's cool, we'll push them all into the pool.
Bobby, I'll make you Attorney General. Just get off my back.
With Bobby.
And Jackie.
And Jack.
The White House is under attack.
8 years is the limit, but 8 will do.
By then, there'll be Bobby.
And Teddy, too.
Or Peter, or Stephen.
Or even you.
And then there's a colonel.
Colonel?
Major?
Major?
You know.
Sergeant.
Yes.
Dozens to take up the slack if anything goes out of whack.
And someday elections will be unknown.
Cause each of our kids will ascend the throne.
And their kids have more kids with kids of their own.
It's sort of a family neck.
Till most of the nation's made up of relations of Bobby and Jackie and Jack. And Ethel and Ted and Eunice and Pat and Joan and Steve and Peter and Jean and Sarge and Joe. Rose and Rose and Rose and Rose and Rose and Rose and Rose. The decade is starting anew. And maybe the country is too.
Ladies and gentlemen, the cast of our review, Frankly Frank, now in its fifth not quite record-breaking month, we'd like to thank you all for coming to the upstairs room at the Downtown Club, where we do two shows every night, with the exception of tonight. We have... Knock it off! Anyway, please come back and bring a friend, or come back and make a friend. Or just come back and be a friend. Thank you.
Excuse me, but I got really excited when I saw your name on the reservation list, Mr. Josephson. Me, I'm just a waiter here. Well, I'm actually holding down three different jobs at the moment, but only until I can get my invention launched. You see, I have invented a brand new machine that will answer your telephone for you if you're not at home, or even if you are. And anyway, I'm just having a little trouble getting all the investors.
But there are answering services with operators already that, guess what? Do exactly for people what you want this fricata machine here to do.
Mr. Josephs, I am looking for only $4,000. Oh. For that, I will right now sign this contract, giving you 50% of the return.
Whoa, I live in a penthouse, kid, not an asylum. Now, I will invest my last red cent when you come up with a sound idea. Something like this new smell-o-vision movie process. When the hell am I ever going to meet a waiter who's just a waiter?
Hello? Mr. and Mrs. Spencer? I'm Mary Flynn. Frank and Beth will be down in less than a minute. You must be really excited about the wedding.
Excited is not the word.
You cannot imagine how important Frank is going to be someday.
No, we can't.
Do you work in the show business too?
Oh, I'm just a fan. But I have never heard music like Frank's.
Us neither.
I work for Look magazine.
Oh, see, now there's a steady, secure job.
I hate it.
Well, maybe that's why they call it work.
Mr. Josephson? Frank Shepherd.
Oh, hi.
Our whole cast is just overwhelmed, is what they are, that such an important man like you would come down to see our little review.
And you recall Shirley Malinsky here, now Gussie Carnegie. She fixed the nose, she fixed the clothes, she fixed the name, and take a look what was underneath all that.
You. I used to work part-time as his secretary to pay for classes.
Oh, we've all seen and admired you on stage so much.
A big talent, wasted on little shows up until me. But you boys must be doing something right, because the fiancé here is going through one hell of a divorce, and you guys made her laugh.
Joe! I thought it was just Peaches.
Oh, see, us, we're usually light years better, but everyone was just so, God, so nervous that the two of you were here. And, well, it's a pretty nerve-wracking night for me anyway. I'm getting married.
Oh, yeah? Is it the girl in the show?
Beth, yeah, Beth.
You're awfully young. Marry in haste. Repent in Reno.
Well, I'm 23. The guy who writes the lyrics is my age, and he has a baby already.
Oh.
Oh, Mr. Josephson, you remember Charles Kringas from the time we auditioned for you? My collaborator?
Yeah, I collabor him, and he collabors me.
Mazel tov. Your stuff's getting more commercial, which is good, because trust me, if you're going to get married, you're going to need bucks. But ask me. I say, unless the girl is pregnant, get out of it. Have a good wedding.
I never forget talented people, Hank.
Frank.
You know, Frank, you don't have to unless you really want to.
But Charlie, I want to.
Frank? If there's any truth at all that we turn out like our parents, you're in big trouble.
Oh, Mary, do you think I'm making the wrong decision?
Well, if you really want to know what I think...
Frank, don't faint, but my parents want to speak with us before the ceremony.
Frank, I'm not pregnant.
What?
Do you still want us to get married?
Well, do you?
Before, my reason was the baby. Now my reason is you.
Well, my reason is you.
I am pregnant.
Beth!
I just wanted to be sure.
Oh.
Elizabeth.
Mommy, how do I look?
Your father and I just want to say one thing, Elizabeth.
Mommy, you've said it all for 2 days.
Well, the man doesn't even have a real job. My daughter told me she's going back to being a legal secretary just to support you.
Mama, I told you that in private.
Mrs. Spencer, what I want to do with my life is not to work in this club. I want to write music. And to be able to do that, I play here. I accompany singers at auditions. I play for dance classes. I do anything I can just to keep on writing music.
Boy, I'm going to give you $2,000 right here, right now. Just call off this sorry excuse for a wedding.
Mr. Spencer, Beth and I are getting married. We hope it's with your blessing, but we're getting married.
The minister just got here.
Where's Evelyn?
Who's Evelyn? The minister, I suppose.
Evelyn is my wife. She's way at the back of the room. See, often they have to stop weddings right in the middle because of her constant sobbing, which I try not to take personally.
Let's start.
Elizabeth?
Here. And here's Grandma's ring. Mama, thank you. Daddy?
Come here.
Well, at least he's not black.
And at least she's not pregnant.
My dear friends. Good evening. Before the marriage vows, Frank and Beth have each asked to speak. Frank.
I'm so happy to be marrying you in the place where I met you and where I grew to love you. Oh, heck, I'm just happy to be marrying you, period. But I want to thank our dear, close friends for being with us on this, well, the most important day of our lives.
Beth.
Not a day goes by, not a single day, but you're somewhere a part of my life, and it looks like you'll stay.
as the days go by. I keep thinking, when does it end? That it can't get much better, much longer. But it only gets better and stronger and deeper and nearer and simpler and freer and richer and clearer. And no, not a day goes by, not a blessed day, but you somewhere come into my life. And you don't go away, and I have to say, if you do, I'll die. I want day after 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 day. Till the days go by. Till the days go by.
Till the days go by.
How does it happen? Once it was all so clear. How did you get so far off the track? Why can't you turn around and go back?
How does it happen? Where is the moment? When did the road behind disappear? Where did you let things slip out of gear? How did you ever get to be here?
1959. 1958.
How's it going?
Good, you?
Fair.
Tell me.
Chinese Laundry.
Hi.
Mary.
Say hello.
I think I got a job.
Where?
True Romances.
Posing?
Thank you. Writing captions.
What about the book?
What about the book?
Nothing. Are you working on the book?
Yes.
Good.
No.
Mary.
Right, I know. Yes, me and Balzac.
Finished the one act.
I got an audition.
I started the story.
Rehearsal pianist.
So where are we eating?
I'm moving to Playboy.
The publisher called me.
I'm doing a rewrite.
My parents are coming.
I saw My Fair Lady.
I rewrote the rewrite.
I sort of enjoyed it.
I threw out the story.
I'm meeting an agent.
We'll all
get together on Sunday. We're opening doors, singing, here we are. We're filling up days on a dime. That faraway shore's looking not too far. We're following every star. There's not enough time.
I called a producer.
I sent off the one act.
I started this story.
He said to come see him.
I dropped out of college.
I met this musician.
I'm playing a nightclub.
They're doing my one act.
I'm working for Red Bull.
I rewrote the ballad.
I finished the story.
We started rehearsals.
I threw out the story and met the musician. I'm moving to Popular Science.
We're opening doors, singing, look who's here. Beginning to sell on a dime. That faraway shore's getting very near. We haven't a thing to fear. We haven't got time.
Come.
number. Kevin.
Hi.
Mary.
Say hello.
I got another job.
Where?
Sheet.
What's that?
A brand new concept. Pop-up pictures.
What about the book?
What about the book?
Did you give the publisher the book?
Yes.
Good.
No.
Mary.
Lineberg.
Finish.
Let me call you back.
Right.
This is just a draft.
Right.
Probably it stinks.
Right.
I haven't had the time to do a polish.
Will you sing?
Right. Who wants to live in New York? Who wants the worries, the noise, the dirt, the heat? Who wants the garbage cans clanging in the street? Suddenly I do. They're always popping their cork. I'll fix that line. The cops, the cabbies, the sales girls up at Saks. You gotta have a real taste for maniacs. Suddenly I do.
That's great. That's swell. The other stuff as well. It isn't every day I hear a score this strong. But fellas, if I may, there's only one thing wrong. There's not a tune you can hum. There's not a tune you go bump, 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 bidum. You need a tune to go bump, 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 bidum. Give me a melody. Why don't you throw them a crumb? What's wrong with letting them tap their toes a bit? I'll let you know when Stravinsky has a hit. Give me a melody. Oh, sure. I know, it's not that kind of show. But can't you write a score that's sort of in between? We'll play a little more, I'll show you what I mean.
Who wants to live in New York? I always hated the dirt, the heat, the noise. But ever since I met you, I...
Listen, boys, maybe it's me. But that's just not a hum-a-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma- guard. Leave your name with a girl. Just write a plain old melody. Dee, 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 dee.
They're stopping rehearsals. They ran out of money.
We lost it when the issue my book was rejected.
The nightclub was raided. I have to start coaching.
My parents are coming.
They screwed up the laundry.
My wallet was stolen.
I saw the musician.
We're being evicted.
I'm having a breakdown.
We'll all get together on Sunday. They're slamming the doors, singing, go away. It's less of a sail than a climb. That faraway shore's farther every day. We're learning to ricochet. We still have a lot to say.
You know what we'll do?
What?
We'll do a review.
What?
What?
We'll do a review of our own.
What?
Where?
Why?
When?
Not just songs, but stories, scenes, piano pieces, mime.
Yeah.
Frankly, Frank.
A showcase of our own.
Where?
The club's reopening.
We'll write out a new stuff.
We'll rewrite old stuff.
What about the girls?
What about the girls?
Only that we're gonna need a girl.
Well, Mary?
Thanks. I don't perform except at dinner.
Who wants to live in New York? Who wants the bodies and noise, the dirt, the heat? Who wants the garbage cans clank? That's as good, yeah.
No!
Who wants to live in New York? Who wants the worry, the noise, the dirt, the heat? Who wants the garbage cans clank? I can't sing higher!
Thank you for coming. Next date, please!
They're always popping their corn.
Up a tone?
The cops, the cabbies, the sales girls up at six.
Up a tone?
You gotta have a real taste for
hired.
I'm Beth.
I'm Frank.
I really thought I stank.
I'm Mary.
Charlie.
By the way, I'm told we open Saturday.
What?
You're not serious.
Nobody's ready.
Apparently somebody canceled the booking.
The songs aren't finished.
What about costumes?
And how do we learn all these numbers?
I'll bring you the copies of everything later this evening.
The singing and song. Do not have to be
sorry.
What do we do about getting home? That's when we'll turn around town. Because they're going to dance. And we'll worry about it on Sunday. We're opening doors. Singing, and here we are. We're filling up days on a dime. That faraway shore's looking not too far. We're following every star. There's not enough time. We're banging on doors, shouting here again. We're risking it all on a dime. That faraway shore's looking near again. The only thing left is when we know we should count to ten. We haven't got time. We haven't got time.
clutching at dreams. Dreams that will explode.
Waking up the countryside.
Everybody merrily, merrily, sing on your song. Rolling along, rolling along,
rolling along.
What are you doing up on the roof?
You know, just came up here.
Well, you could have told a person.
You were asleep.
Yeah, the alarm just went off. Hey, you see anything?
Uh-uh.
Something wrong?
Nope.
What are you doing up here so early?
I couldn't sleep. Oh, Charlie, I read your two plays last night. They were so wonderful, I couldn't sleep.
I thought you were mad. I have to tell everyone who stays over to always wake me whenever they think I'm wonderful.
Well, I just kept tossing and turning and thinking about wasting these last 2 years in the army and then to come back and read your plays.
Wasting? What about that music you played for me? Talk about wonderful.
What? Really?
Yeah. Frank, you don't just write what you know. You write what you know.
Okay, this play, Pretty Politics, the one about the Senate pages, what do you think about making it into a musical?
Go on.
I got a better title. Take a Left.
That's a better title?
But I think it's important. Musicals are popular, you know? They're a great way to state important ideas. Ideas that can really make a difference. Charlie, we could change the world. Something is stirring. Shifting ground, it's just begun. Edges are blurring all around, and yesterday is done. Feel the flow, hear what's happening, wear what's happening. Don't you know? We're the movers and we're the shapers. We're the names in tomorrow's papers. Up to us, man, to show. It's our time, breathe it in. Worlds to change and worlds to win. Our turn coming through. Me and you, man, me and you.
Oh.
Oh, hi.
We just wanted to, my roommate and... Excuse me.
She's probably from Barnard. Barnard girl's a dippy.
Do you have the time?
Quarter to six. You ever think about getting married?
No.
Me neither. When I'm a lot older, maybe.
Feel how it quivers on the brink.
What?
Everything. Gives you the shivers. Makes you think there's so much stuff to sing. And you and me will be singing it like the birds. Me with music and you the words. Tell them things they don't know. Up to us, pal, to show them. Our time, breathe it in. Worlds to change and worlds to turn, we're what's new. Me and you, pal, me and you. Feel the flow,
feel the flow.
Hear what's happening, we're what's happening. Long ago, all we had was that funny feeling, saying someday we'd send them reeling. Now it looks like we can. Someday just began.
It's our heads on the block. Give us room and start the clock. Our time coming through. Me and you, pal. Me and you. Me and you.
I didn't mean to be so overdressed before. Am I too late?
What? No, no, I think it's just about now.
My roommate's coming up, too.
I'm Charlie Kringas. This is Frank Shepard.
Mary Flynn.
Hi.
We just took the apartment on 5.
Oh, I'm not officially moved in yet. Not until I'm discharged from the Army next week.
And Frank got a weekend pass to help us move in. A lot to move in. A typewriter, 2 mattresses, and a piano.
Oh, well, you're the one playing the piano the last 2 days.
We're evicted.
Mm-hmm. Oh, no, no, you're wonderful. Sincerely wonderful.
Well, I'm sincerely grateful.
I even came up here on the roof to hear you better. I tell everything, then go home and suffer. Are you sincerely wonderful, too?
I write.
Oh, he is.
Me, Columbia. Him, Juilliard.
That's what I want to do. Write. But how does anyone compose music, though? To me, that is the gift of gifts.
I just met the girl I ought to marry. Did anyone ever tell you you say all the right things?
Never. But I really want to know.
Well, music is, it's not about words. It's about sounds and feelings and, oh gosh, I don't know. To me, music is about everything, so.
Anyway, so creative.
If I didn't have music, I'd die.
Someday, Frank is going to be a very important composer.
He is? I think you already are.
Mary! Mary, I... Oh! You're with guys!
Evelyn! Evelyn! That was Evelyn.
We should look now. It's supposed to be right now.
Do you see anything?
I hope we didn't miss it. It's supposed to come up right over there. There it is.
Oh, I see it.
But where?
There, it's over there.
It's just phenomenal.
Phenomenal. Do you call it Sputnik or Sputnik?
You call it a miracle. God.
We've got to be the luckiest people who ever lived. After this moment... This moment the three of us are sharing here together. Nothing is ever going to be the way it is. Ever again. Do you guys realize that now we're going to be able to do anything? I mean, anything we ever dreamed of. What a time to be starting out. What a time to be alive. Something is stirring, shifting ground. It's just begun.
Edges are blurring all around, and yesterday is done.
Feel the flow, hear what's happening.
Hear what's happening.
Don't you know? We're the movers and we're the shapers. We're the names in tomorrow's papers. Up to us now to show on.
It's our time, breathe it in. Worlds to change and worlds to win. Our turn coming through. Me and you, pal, me and you.
Years from now, we'll remember and we'll come back by the rooftop and hang a plaque. This is where we began. Being what we can.
It's our heads on the block. Give us room.